Start.
So welcome back. So as you can see, today I will discuss about Beyer-Spillager oxidation. Don't need to worry about this. I will come to this little bit later. First, we should know about what is Beyer-Spillager oxidation. It is nothing, just insertion of oxygen in. It can be any a cyclic ketone or a cyclic ketone, right? So the reagent used in Beyer-Spillager oxidation is our peracids. Like here I am giving you an example. This is our peracid and this is our cyclic ketone. And what I said earlier, it is insertion of oxygen. Right, so it can form these two products. So in this lecture we will discuss which product is going to form, right? So before proceeding to that, we should know about some basics about Beyer-Spillager oxidation. First of all, it is carbon to oxygen rearrangement type of reaction. Why carbon to oxygen, or what it looks like, we will discuss, right? So if we go through its mechanism part, first of all I want to wrap this part. So what I said you, that suppose it is R dash and we take up our acid, right? Since this acid is very strong, then the protonation, then the removal of hydrogen due to high acidity is going to take place, and this hydrogen will, this proton will attack to this oxygen. Means protonation will occur, right? And due to this, the electrophilicity of this carbon is going to increase, right? So there will be a nucleophilic attack on this carbonyl center. Just write it in this form for your convenience. So what I said earlier, it is a rearrangement type of reaction in which a carbon to oxygen rearrangement is going to take place. So this alkyl group, either this or this, depends totally upon the migratory aptitude, right? So suppose for this time we say that the R dash is having higher migratory aptitude. So it will migrate here and this will migrate here. Sorry, before this migration, it is compulsory, right? So here again, oxygen will carry the positive charge, and this and be left with this ion which will remove this proton, right? So our final product will be a ester, right? So this is the little bit scheme about the Beyer-Spillager oxidation. And one thing I want to tell you, that if you go through some books, and what you will see that in some books the migratory aptitude order is somewhat different, and in other book they give you a different order. So I recommend you to go through this book, because it is taken from Jackie. So it should be correct, right? So first our tertiary alkyl, then the cyclohexyl, and then the secondary alkyl, followed by benzyl, phenyl, primary alkyl, methyl, and at last hydrogen will come, right? So the trick of this reaction, what you will see, suppose again I am taking just this example. You see there is a presence of carbonyl group. To the carbonyl group we have two groups, R dash and R. Suppose R dash is having higher migratory aptitude, what you will do, just insert an oxygen between the group which is having higher migratory aptitude and the carbonyl carbon, right? So this will be our final product. Let's discuss some examples so that it can clarify you. Right? Suppose we have this example and we take a metachloro MCPBA, metachloro perbenzoic acid, it is also a parasite. Then what I said earlier, the tertiary chiral is having higher migratory aptitude. Just insert the oxygen between the group which is having higher magnitude and the carbonyl carbon, right? So if we take another example, suppose we have a MCPBA. Now either oxygen can insert between this group and this group, this one is secondary and this one is tertiary, right? So what will be our product? Right, this will be your product. So it is a very easy reaction and you just need to go through some problems. You can pick any book. So let's discuss about some cases which you will not found in every book. Suppose we have a 1,2 diketone, right? We have 1,2 diketone and we use MCPBA. Now what you will think generally, some of may insert oxygen here and or some may, because both groups are same, so some may insert oxygen here or some one may here, but the product is same and some can also insert oxygen in both the species, in both the methyl group. But in that case, if we have 1,2 diketo and we use MCPBA, then our product, then the insertion of oxygen is between 2 diketo, right? So this will be our final product in case of 1,2 diketo, right? So another example I want to discuss. Right, and we take MCPBA. So again the oxygen is going to be inserted here. So I am writing the direct product, right? So this will be our final product. Now discuss some example which is exceptionally important. I am writing it in case of bicyclic compound. Right, what I want to say, in case of bicyclic compound, if there is a steric hindrance, means what I want to say, if they, suppose there is a competition between steric hindrance and migratory aptitude, right? So the product will be formed according to the steric hindrance, right? So for the more clarification, let's discuss about some example, but this is only valid in case of bicyclic compound. Now suppose we have a substrate like this and we have MCPBA. In that case there is no steric hindrance, right? So this one is secondary, this one is tertiary. So what will be our product? It is as general. The insertion of oxygen is going to take place between the tertiary carbon and this ketone, right? Let's take another example in which there is 2 methyl group, right? And we have an ketone group like that. It is also a simple case, not an exceptional case, because the bulkiness of the steric factor of both the methyl groups is equal to this moiety as well as this moiety, right? So again you see this is tertiary and this is secondary. So what will be our product? This one is oxygen, and right, sorry, this one be our product. This one we would kind of put. So let's take another example. Right. So now in that case the steric hindrance factor, I'm writing it, is dominated upon migratory aptitude factor, right? Because this methyl group, due to this methyl group, there will be a steric crowdedness. So what we will see in general, that the product is going to form from the this side, but no, in that case, due to steric hindrance, the product is going to form this will be the final. So I suggest you to please go through CAL authors, in which you can see all type of example which are exceptionally important. I can't go through all the examples, but I have already explained you, in case of steric in case of bicyclic compound, you have to look about the steric hindrance factor, right? So I want to discuss one or two more example, like MCPB, right? Always remember one thing: if we take a MCPB and if we have a substrate, right, and in a substrate we have any pi electron density, or we can say that we have any alkene group, right, then the MCPB will always attack first to this group. Why? Because MCPB is our electrophilic type of agent, because due to high electron density, it can attack to this center to form the epoxide. So what will be our final product? Right, so this will be our final product. Now suppose you want to the oxygen insertion in this type of substrate, so just see, and you want to avoid the addition of MCPB to this double bond, and just simply say that you want to avoid the formation of epoxide, then just simply take H2O2. Right, so it will form this product. Right, so this example is very important, and I also want to discuss one more example which is a exceptional case, and examiner also want to give some exceptional case in the paper so that you may confuse. We have MCPB, so please don't confuse. In my last action, what I have said that if MCPB is present, then it will always attack to the double bond first. But this is an exceptional case, so it will not attack to this double bond and forming epoxide. Just simply the addition of oxy. So it is just a simple Beckmann rearrangement. Beyers Villiger oxidation, and we have a tertiary alkyl group. So the So this one will be our final product. So that's enough for today. So thank you for watching my video, and please like, subscribe and share.